There are only about two handfuls of games running on the CliffX engine, each featuring different levels of workability or how much can be modified or being able to create custom content for them, like mapping, either by official or unofficial delivered tools to do so. The list of games at the given point in time in a descending order are the 8-bit series games, which primarily includes 8-bit Invaders, 8-bit Hordes and 8-bit Armies, a series of RTS games released in the course of half a year from early to late 2016, Battle Battalions, a mobile RTS game released in late 2015, Grey Goo, an RTS game released in early 2015, Rise of Immortals, Battle for Graxia, a MOBA released in mid-2011 and re-released in late 2012. Guardians of Graxia, a digital card game released in late 2010. Mythion, an RPG title originally released in mid-2010 and re-released in late 2015. Panzer General, Allied Assault, another digital card game released in the third quarter of 2009. Universe at War, Earth Assault, an RTS game published in the end of 2007, early 2008. Star Wars Empire War and its expansion pack Star Wars Empire War, Force of Corruption, both RTS games released in early to late 2006. Also known as Star Wars Empire War Gold Pack on Steam. There may not be a lot of games, and almost all of them being within the realms of RTS, MOBA or RPG, though the amount that supports official mapping or modding tools to other them in any way at all is actually pretty low. And also, Rise of Immortals Battles for Graxia was shut down in mid-2013 and has therefore been unavailable to play ever since. For those games supporting custom mapping with a public released version of their level editor, the first in stack is the 8-bit series games. Here, 8-bit Armies, 8-bit Hordes and 8-bit Invaders each come with their own level editor pre-packed and found in their main folder in the Steam directory. Even though each has their own level editor since they're separate games, they all feature the exact same and updated as one, as the games use a cross-multiplayer functionality, with the only difference being each uploads to their specific workshop respectively. These editors only have support for the creation of basic custom maps for the multiplayer-focused intended playstyle, and are also in addition unable to ship with any sort of custom content such as textures, props or objects. For Grey Goo on the other hand, which is the next game, there are a lot more features available for what is possible for level designers to mess around with, and is actually the one with the most public tools available. As like the 8-bit games, it of course functions for the choice to create multiplayer gameplay maps, but it furthermore also offers more in-editor support for what are either locked away or unused in 8-bit, such as the grass tab and textures for the Cliff paintbrush. There can too be built almost fully fledged campaigns with this version of the CliffX editor, with scripting in a custom syntax-directed programming language designed internally for Grey Goo specifically, called ClickScript, found in Tools, Launch ClickScript Editor in the Map Editor, and with three, maybe a bit too in-depth, official documentations on the Grey Goo website for how to use the terrain editor provided, being able to create the campaign maps themselves, but also how to code in ClickScript with all of its possibilities for creating custom community scenarios through the workshop. On top of it all, there can as well be imported custom assets such as props to user-designed maps with the Goo Asset Tools plugin for the 32-bit version of 3DX Max 2013. Links for all of these can be found in the description. Last but not least, Star Wars Empire War and Star Wars Empire War Force of Corruption, which actually do not run on CliffX but its predecessor, the Alamo engine, that despite being older functions almost in the exact same way, just with a less rich feature set. Both games offers each a public release level editor, but sadly with the recent update to the Steam version of the games, they have become somewhat broken and will therefore only work with either workarounds by using older versions of the games from before the update until a fix has been rolled up by Petroglyph, which is probably already out after the release of this video, or by using non-Steam versions. The level editors themselves who gives the ground to build standard single player or multiplayer maps, and it's therefore not a thing to create campaigns in the editor without mods, but like with Grey Goo, there is too a tool provided to create and implement custom props into the game slash maps, but because of its age might only work with other kinds of 3DX Max, like version 6, 8 and 9. The different level editors for the games will really only work to create maps for the specific game they are made for, and it is therefore not possible to use another's level editor to build one's maps, not only because of missing content, but compatibility reasons too. with the exception of if they run on the same branch and it being a newer version of the engine. For example, it is possible to open Grey Goose maps with the 8-bit map editors as they use the same branch but an updated version of the Grey Goose Glyph X engine, but not the other way around. It is possible too to open the 8-bit games maps in each other's editors as the version of the engine is the same and has the same content and is nearly identical games but with different default content unlocked. 8-bit Games supports a slight amount of official modding with full text translation replacements that, like it sounds, allows for the change of all in-game text to be overwritten with just a couple of files, and works for both static text and audio texting, aka subtitles. All of the default music tracks and unit sounds may to be changed on choice by renaming the desired sound file for the Switch to the one that shall be replaced, following a given naming scheme noted in the help text files provided, which all of it in its entirety can be found in the given 8-bit games data mods folder. Grey Goose, despite having more possibilities for mapping than any other game on the list, has no form for official modding available whatsoever, and as such everything that might regularly mind or bigger changes to the game has to be done either through custom mapping or by unofficial means via community created tools for the amount that those are able to help on the matter for it. Star Wars Empire War and Star Wars Empire War Force of Corruption also do not really have that much official support for modding, other than its acceptance, allowance and encouraged by developers to do so, through the accounts for mostly all of their bigger titles. But with their file structures and file type choices of TXT, XML, Lua and datfiles, etc., it is built with an overall simplicity for what could have been, making modding a lot easier. Moreover, with the popularity and age of the games, there is to be made a lot of modding tutorials, community tools and moddb pages for most of these petroglyph games specifically for what is needed to get started to modify it. And also with the recent update to the Gold Pack Steam version at the 1st of September 2017 and mentioned earlier, it is now possible to upload a created mod on the workshop, where Grey Goose and the 8-bit games only support maps, instead of moddb only to get the attention of a bigger portion of the player base, increasing the popularity of a mod and thereby keeping the community alive for longer. For the unofficial modding tools, there is a bunch provided at modtools.petrolution.net. is the main source for modification software for petroglyphs games to varying degrees depending on the game itself. Even having downloads and patches for the official tools is provided elsewhere so that they will not become forgotten or lost over time. One of the most important tools is the Megafile Editor that is used for accessing the meg files that stores all of a game's main content, which to be copied and replaced by the use of the engine's hierarchy loading system as long as they follow the overall sub path for not only single file replacement via the data folder, but as well can be set to look for the game's files from a selected mod path first before anything else, being the way modifications are loaded.